In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can activate all 7 great runes in Elden Ring. This is going to be a complete walkthrough of how you can activate these runes that you are seeing right now. As you can see, all are active. I'm going to show every single location that you have to go and how you unlock every single one of them. So we just have to start with the first one. I'm going to take them in order because, yeah, I think there is an order. And we're going to discuss about every single one of them. We're gonna talk about first the Godrick's great rune, the first one that you are seeing right now on the screen. That is the first one from the list. Basically, if you want to activate this one, the Godrick's great rune, you'll have to go to the Stormveil castle. I'm pretty sure obviously you've been there because you defeated Godrick and you got his great rune, and you'll have to reach to this location, to the Limegrave tower bridge. We're gonna start the journey from this chamber, from the lift chamber. This is where I got the rune, and everything is going to be a little bit on fast forward, so stay with me. If you think something is too fast, you have the option to slow it down a little bit from you have that option from YouTube. As you can see, nothing is active right now, only one is activated, but we're going to discuss about that later in this video, that it's a special one. Now you'll have to go here on the left. If you want, you can clear your path by defeating these enemies. Not like I just did. I don't know what I'm doing sometimes. But this is the path that you have to take. Just go down. Keep going. Don't stop for anyone. There are going to be a lot of enemies right over here. Here, if you're going to see a lion, don't worry about that. You just have to outrun that lion. It's something like a lion or an animal. And you'll want to enter to this. Bro, how much do you follow me? How long do you follow me? Now, we have this these soldiers, and you'll have to enter to this building. Bridge, I don't know what is that. Yeah, it's a bridge. Take that grace, definitely take that grace, because maybe you may die right over here to the Stoneville bridge. You're gonna see 3 big giants that you can again outrun them. You don't have to fight those guys. Everything is gonna be explained, so don't worry about that. Now keep going until you reach a portal. The portal will be at the end of this bridge. You cannot miss it. Oh bro, okay, that was harsh. Now here we're gonna have the portal. Just travel to this location and you're gonna be teleported right over where the break has been, as you can see, that the part of the other part of the bridge where the bridge has been crashed. Now you'll have to enter to these doors, to these big stone doors, and you'll see a big elevator that's gonna take you a while to be there. Also, at the end of this video, I'm gonna show you how you can activate and how you can use them. This is only how you can restore the power of the great runes, and at the end I'm going to show you how you can activate it and how they work. But you cannot do that part if you don't do the first one, the one that you are seeing right now. Obviously, the first part that you have to do is to restore those great runes. So this will be your first. Just go next to that shiny thing, that circle, and just activate it. Now you have activated Godrick's great rune. Cool. It's time to let me show you how it looks in your inventory. Right there it is. And now it's time to go to the second one. We're gonna start the journey from here, from this location. But let me show you how we can be here from the first step. Basically, the easiest way to be there is to reach the third church of Marika, and behind that church there is a portal. With that portal, you're gonna be teleported to the bestial sanctum right over here, and you have to follow this path right down there. Take this path, and at a certain point you'll reach this location, Dragon Barrow West. And from this location you want to be very careful, because I died a few times trying to get there. I'm gonna show you why. This will be the Radahn great rune. I think I had to, yeah, the next one in line, it was the snake, the Rykard great rune, but I put them in order how I defeat those main bosses. Now you'll want to see this tower and just go straight to that tower. That's gonna be the biggest tower that you will see, and just jump on this tree. Be careful not to die. You can follow my path, exactly what I'm doing, but if not, if you have a better way to go up there, do it your in your own way. But I'm gonna show you how I did it in my way here. Just grab your horse. You'll have to take the next ladder right over here, climb. Again, be very careful not to fall, because yeah, it can be frustrating if you fall more than one time, trust me, until you'll find the first grace, because that then you are safe. Now here you can jump right there on the right, but I failed that jump. Don't worry, you can do it even if you failed, like I'm doing right now. Just go straight forward and you will see this ladder that you have to take. You will see a nice item right over here. A lot of runes you will get from that. The new man's rune. Nice. And just grab. I like it with my horse because I think it's a little bit safer on those edges. And take the last ladder, I think it will be. Very high. Okay, now go on the left, you will see the grace, and from now on you are safe. Divine Tower of Kyld. And from this location you just want to climb up and up until you will see these doors. Open them and the beloved elevator. Take the elevator, and you at the top of this building you're gonna see the next great rune that you can activate, the Radahn's one. Pretty easy, just go on the right here. You go. I told you everything is on fast forward. If you think it's something too fast, you have the options to slow it down a little bit. Now the Radahn great rune is right over there. Now it's time to head up to the next one, and the next one will be a little bit more interesting. You have to defeat one secondary boss, not something like a main boss, but definitely have to defeat someone to get there. Already we have two, and with the special one we have three. Actually go to the capital, to the edge of the capital. So this will be the boss that we have to defeat. Obviously you just defeated the boss from the Volcano Manor, and the path from the first step is gonna be, let me show you, just take it right over here, go up, bypass the Stormway Castle right over here, go to the lakes, and at a certain point you're gonna reach the capital, Grand Lift of Decatus. You'll need a medallion. If you don't know how to be there, don't worry, a link it will be in this video description how you can get that medallion. And from that lift of the Grand Lift of Decatus, you'll want to be to the outer wall Phantom Tree right over there. We're gonna start the journey, and from the outer wall Phantom Tree, let me show where we have to go. This is the rune that we're gonna activate. Just go right over there in that direction and a little bit on the left. Don't jump, yeah, because you might die. And now just go down until you reach a secret cave. That cave is pretty hard to reach for me. It was pretty hard to reach, but finally I got it. No, a little bit, I think it's on the left, yes. And now this cave has a lot of invisible walls. I'm gonna explain how you can enter. This will be another grace that you have to take. Definitely take this one. And when you see that fire, you will just have an invisible wall that you can pass. So just go right over there and hit that wall. Here you can hit the invisible walls and you can get past. Now go a little bit on the right, keep it on the right. You will see another invisible wall right over here. Some enemies you don't have to defeat those if you don't like to. You will see an elevator, obviously take the elevator, and I think two or three more invisible walls we have to take. Now another one will be here, keep going, another one will be here, and now just jump on that tree, jump here. So annoying. And here when you're gonna reach this point, you want to go on the right side, right here, jump, be careful of those stones, and again on the right end where just go here. You're gonna have another invisible wall, but I have to admit I died once here because I fell off. Definitely be very careful when you try to jump down there. That's why I'm gonna show you every step of the way. Another exploding rocks, and now right over here you'll see the boss. We have to search for everything, but here is gonna be the boss from this area that we have to defeat, because you cannot pass to activate that gray rune of Rykard if you don't defeat this boss. Pretty easy boss if you ask me, and I have a video on my channel how you can defeat this one if you don't know how to do it. Now it's time to move on. As you can see, the door has opened and we have to get out to activate Rykard Great Rune. Another big doors. By the way, the next tower is gonna activate two runes, so less work for you. You don't have to travel a lot for the Morgott and Mohg rune. Morgott, I think it's called, yes. Take the elevator. And bro, how tall is this tower? After you're gonna take this elevator, you'll have to take this grace. Go on the right, West Altus Tower. Here it's gonna be the next great rune that you can activate. Basically, these great runes give you a lot of power if you activated them with the arc runes. That it's a special item that you can buy or find. So this will how it's gonna look activated. And this is the location. Now we're gonna go to the next two, to the next ones. Here you can activate them, but you know what, let's go to the next, to the, because I told you the next two they're gonna be in the same spot. Basically, you have to unlock the forbidden lands. If you don't know how to do that, again a link, it will be in this video description. From the capital you have to defeat a boss, Godfrey, I think you have to defeat, something like that. But if you don't know how to be to the snowlands, don't worry, again I have a video on my channel how you can be there. But I'm gonna count that a lot of you already unlocked that location. That's why I don't want to make an hour long video to show you how to get to the forbidden lands. But basically this is the path. Now just go back to this building. You'll have to take an elevator. Also from the capital, you can, after you're gonna open that secret, that big door, you can be here. So you're gonna see two ways that you can get out. That one with a knight, with a horse, and this one that we're gonna get with just a soldier with a torch in the hand. Here you're gonna fight, you're gonna be like invaded from two bosses, from the fell twins, something like that. You have to defeat those guys if you want to pass to that tower. Not a hard fight. Again, I have that fight on my channel. If you want to know how to, you can defeat those guys. If they gonna give you trouble, I have the video on my channel. Right now, we're gonna have another grace on the right side, at the main gate. And basically, you want to take the same elevator. And again, you are lucky because here we're gonna activate two great runes. The Morgott, and Mohg. I have them both on me, but if you have only one, you can be here to activate only one. Don't worry. Go on the right, the same path. I think you're gonna have another grace right up there. Yes. On the right side, and as you can see, this one it's a little bit different, it's looking a little bit different because two great runes are here, the red one and this glowing one, golden. I don't even know what color is that, but yeah, it's there. So this is for the Morgott, and the red one is for the Mohg. So yeah, these two. I forgot to record when I activated the Mohg one, but this is how the first one looks like. Okay, Morgott, great rune. And the second one, basically it's about the same. I already activated. You just have to go touch that grace, that red circle, and you'll get also the Mohg one. Now we are down to the final and the most interesting one, the Malenia's great rune, which is a pretty hard to get location, depends, but it's a pretty hard to get to defeat boss, the Malenia, one of the hardest boss that I encountered in this game so far. That's why I'm gonna show how we can activate her great rune, because you fight a lot to defeat and you deserve it. Now this will be the location where am I right now, but pretty hard to reach, right? Looks. But I'm gonna show you the simplest way. Basically, we have two different ways if you want to activate that great rune of Malenia. You'll have to reach the capital. Depends. If you are late in the game with the Ash capital, with the capital Ashen, after you burn down the tree, you will have to take a different path. But I'm gonna assume that already you have unlocked the Divine Bridge. If not, don't worry. I'm gonna show you also the second method. Again, this will be the first method, the method where you just unlock the Divine Bridge, and you just want to go to the Divine Bridge. As you can see, this elevator will not work. This I wanted to show you. This elevator will not work after the Ashen capital. So after you burn down the tree, the capital will become ash and it will change forever. Now, or until the game plus. Now you have to take this portal. And from this portal, you're gonna unlock this location that I was just been there. Now I'm gonna show also the second method. For those of you who don't have that location that I just showed you, you'll want to be right over here, and to the bottom part of the map, you want to reach the isolated merchant shack. Not a hard to get location. And from this location, you want to go to the Tower of Return. No major boss to have fight here. Basically, you don't have to fight anyone if you don't like to. Only one soldier. It's right there at the top of that hill. And when you reach that, you have to climb some ladders to get to a trapped teleport chest. You wanna be trapped in that teleport chest, I think that it's how it's called. And you're gonna be, let me show you, right over here. And when you will activate this, you would have entered into the transport trap. Yeah, transport trap it's called. And you're gonna be in the same location. If you didn't unlock that grace, now you have the option to unlock it. And from this location, now it's time for us to activate that great rune of Malenia. Isolated divine tower, it will be right over here, and this elevator Malenia. Yeah, I just wanted to show where is Malenia, right up there. If you didn't defeat her and you watch this video, definitely want to go to that boss, to the Hyle Tree main boss, but be prepared because it's a hard one. Now you're gonna be at the top of this tower, take the grace, go on the right side, exactly like you just did with the previous towers. And now with this one, with the last one, I'm gonna show you also how you can use those great runes, because now you activate them and you have to use them. First you have to equip them and then you have to activate them. This is how you can restore it. Now Malenia great rune is restored. The next thing that you want to do is to go to your which one with whatever grace you like. Just go to a grace site and then just let me show how they look. Now all we have them are activated. Let me show you how you can make it, how you can equip it, because yeah, you can choose only one great rune, we cannot choose more than one. Basically you want to go to that grace and choose it, which one, which whatever you like. Let's say we're gonna use the Malenia great rune, and you have to go, after you're gonna equip it, you have to go in your inventory. If you have, basically I think you're gonna have a rune arc, you have to use that rune arc and it's gonna be active, it's gonna glow right there on the left side. Now let's talk about the last one, the seventh great rune, the Renala's great rune. This is the only one that you don't have to activate. Basically you have to defeat Renala. If you don't know how to find her and how you can defeat her, I have a video on my channel of how you can do that. It's gonna be right over here to the Royal Lucaria Academy, and with this one you don't have to activate, you cannot put it on, you cannot equip it, but this has a purpose. This gonna rebirth you. You're gonna have to use this with a larvar tier, and you're gonna reset all your points, all your stats. Maybe some of you don't know already, you don't know that, and I just wanted to show you how that works. You have to be here if you want to use it, you cannot do it from any other place. So basically you want to enter to the Royal Lucaria Academy, it's gonna be a key to that island, and to the Royal Lucaria Grand Library is gonna be the location. We're gonna have to talk with Renala, and then you're gonna use that item that I just showed you. And also we have this option to change some things, nice cosmetics, but we are not here to discuss about that. Rebirth is the one that you're gonna, that you want to do with that great rune. That great rune is gonna help you to rebirth, so basically you can reset everything in matter of points and you can put them wherever you like. Let me show you that item, and that's it. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Like, subscribe, share, press that notification bell for more videos like this. And this was the complete tutorial of how you can activate all 7 great runes, 6 plus the bonus one. Bro, where is that item? Larvar tier, here we go. This requires for you to make a rebirth. Bye.